9 miles an hour, AC on, no drone. About 4,000 miles to break in, we're pretty good, so it sounds a little bit more grumblier than when I first installed it. And that was me stepping on the accelerator pedal for a split second and backing off. Just gonna go for a little drive, just kind of get to hear the what the exhaust sounds like, and I have to include the cold air intake because honestly it made a difference. And so I'm gonna do a couple of different runs, you know, like not, you know, just driving normally how I normally do, and then of course I'll get on it a little bit, but I'm gonna do that like with windows open and close and stuff like that. So right now I'm just, I have the max AC on setting 1, because I need a little bit of AC, so if that, if you start hearing, you know, like excessive air noise, that's what that is. I'm just cruising at 50 miles an hour. The one thing I wanted to talk about with people before we can carry on with this quote review, so to say, is that I knew when I was buying it that it was not going to be the loudest cat-back exhaust out there for these trucks. I wasn't going for that. I was looking for the better free-flowing, well, okay, number one, the quality, the better flow, the performance, and of course efficiency, and the better, throatier, nicer sound over stock. Now, probably thinking, well, there's a lot of exhausts that do that and they sound a lot better. There likely is, but I was prepping the truck for a when and if. And that would be, yeah, this guy's gonna take a sweet ass time to turn. Okay, thank you. When I decide to do long tube headers with a mid pipe upgrade, I wanted to keep the Cat-Back exhaust more tame, and then I'll let the headers and mid pipe do the talking, if that makes any sense. And what I mean by that is, I wanted to have more tame Cat-Back while the headers and mid-pipe would be a lot more opened up, because if I had a completely unleashed header and a mid-pipe upgrade, which is that's what it is, long tube headers with this specific mid-pipe that I want, that's completely unleashed, you know, so much free flowing, you know, better power, so much better sound, and that's exactly what that is. And if I doubled that up with a completely unleashed screaming Cat-Back, the truck's gonna sound like crap, and it's gonna be super irritating to listen to. It's gonna, you know, drive you nuts, and if it doesn't drive me nuts, it's gonna piss off everybody else. So what I was looking for with the more tame Cat-Back, of course the quality and the better, you know, of course the better sound and performance level, of course I was looking for that, you know, with the header and mid-pipe upgrade. I was looking for just to have the nicer tone while it's driving, but it's not going to be screaming the entire time the engine is running. So this way, I can have it doable and tolerable, and everybody else can tolerate it when I'm driving, and then when I step on it, that's when it'll scream. And that's what I was looking for. And again, it's a when and if. You can hold me to it. I don't know if I'll ever upgrade to long tube headers and mid-pipe. It'd probably take a little while. I don't know. But that was the goal. And if I never do upgrade, if I never put another dime in this truck as far as upgrades go, no problem. I very much enjoy the Cat-Back and the cold air intake that I have done, that I've got for it. The other thing that I absolutely forgot to mention, and I should have mentioned, was the other thing I was looking for, and one of the top, well, I think it is tied between number one and two of a priority, no drone. Corsa exhausts are specifically designed not to drone. Whether it be they just have a nice upgraded exhaust for a specific vehicle, or for something like a Mustang, Camaro, and Challenger, they offer three different levels of sound. Like they got the Corsa Touring, Sport, and Extreme. No matter what it is, Corsa exhausts, the whole Corsa's muffler systems are specifically designed not to drone. In fact, they look for that first before they look for anything else. And I really liked that on top of the quality. So, but as you can tell, I'm just driving around. It's quiet. You don't really hear anything. When you get on it, you'll hear the intake and Cat-Back exhaust. And I typically say Cat-Back exhaust, and I religiously say it because I don't want people confusing other exhaust components with it. Because right now, the rest of the exhaust is stock. It has the factory manifolds, exhaust manifolds, and a factory mid-pipe, and my mid-pipe has four catalytic converters on it, and they only did that for these new body style trucks from 04 to 08, they only did that for the 04 models, because in 05 to 08 they switched it to two, but they're slightly bigger than one of the catalytic converters. Each cat is a little bit bigger than one you would find on this 04 truck. So, just a little bit of a, hey, did you know that? I'd like to live in that house. There ain't nobody else around. It's quiet. Alright, so here's the new drive shaft, and actually you could see part of the Corsa Cat-Back exhaust I got. I've never once gotten under here and cleaned it or nothing. You really kind of can't. But anyway. Yeah, it's the new drive shaft, alright. Yeah, the old one looked like crap. And I was always worried about it. I was like, you know, one of these days I should replace it, but, yeah, and it ended up happening, so there's that, and then here's the Cat-Back. That's the factory piping right there. That's where it starts new. Yep. Goody.